Good morning to everyone. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to this conference to present here our work. That's a work on magneto-responsive surfaces for manipulation of light and liquid, and this is a cooperative work between the University of Ljubljana, Jozef Stefan Institute in Ljubljana, and between East Bavarian Technical High School in Regensburg. The work is focused on magnetic composite materials. And before I explain you our composite material, I would like to remind you of two other composite materials that you very probably already know. First of these materials are magnetorheological fluids. These are colloidal suspensions of micron-sized magnetizable particles in a non-magnetic fluid. Typically, this is an oil. And they form this very nice flower-like structure when they're exposed to magnetic fields. So that's why one can very often see them in science centers or in different science festivals. Another such type of magnetic composites are magnetic rubbers. These are materials that we know from magnetic stickers, and they are also present in the gasket for sealing the doors of our refrigerators and so on. And these are magnetized particles which are embedded in a typical elastomer matrix, which have a Young modulus of several megapascal. And what about our properties or our materials? These are magnetoactive elastomers, which are also known as magnetorheological elastomers. And they have micron-sized magnetizable particles, which are embedded in a very soft elastomer matrix. This matrix has a Young modulus below 100 kilopascal, and it's soft like human skin, or even softer. And what is very specific about magnetoactive elastomers is that they have experienced very large changes in their mechanical and other physical properties as a function of magnetic field. For instance, where they are out of the magnetic field, they behave like very soft rubber balloons. But when they are exposed to magnetic field, they actually become like plasticine or like a putty, they become plastic. And in between low and high magnetic field, they strongly change the shear modulus and the Young modulus as a function of magnetic field. This increase in the values of the shear modulus can be several orders of magnitude. And this effect is known as the giant magnetorheological effect. What is the reason for such giant changes induced by the magnetic field? The main reason is restructuring of the magnetic filler particles. The filler particles are typical soft iron, like carbonyl iron microparticles embedded in a poly-DMS matrix. And so these particles are spherical of different sizes. Typical size or diameter is several micrometers, and they are, in the absence of magnetic field, isotropically distributed in the polymer matrix. But when magnetic field is applied, they start to form chains of these magnetized microparticles, and this chain formation actually changes and affects the mechanical and other properties. And we can see here on this image that also surface, of course, can be changed due to this restructuring in the volume of the material. And we are actually interested in this surface modification. And what can be so interesting, if we can change surface with a magnetic field, this can be, for instance, used to tune optical properties of the surface, such as reflectivity. Or we can tune wetting properties for different liquids, such as contact angle, surface tension, and contact line pinning. And we will also show you that also droplet splashing characteristics can be tuned. For instance, corona splashing versus the normal deposition of the droplet. We believe that this is not the end of the story, of course. There are many other properties. So we believe also adhesion properties are strongly modified with magnetic field. Some surface patterns can be formed, which then can also be changed by magnetic field. So there is still a lot of playground available in this field. So here I would like to switch now to our research. So we are using, as I already mentioned, carbonyl iron in the PDMS matrix. Typical concentration that we are using is 70 to 88% of microparticles, and the recipe for the preparation is fabricated since some years. And they have such a shape of disc with the diameter of 20 millimeters and the thickness of a few millimeters. And we apply magnetic field by simply using a permanent magnet, which is moved by a translation stage closer or more far from the sample. And so by this way, we can change magnetic field between about 0 and 0.25 Tesla. So first property that we were analyzing was a modification of optical reflection from the surface. These materials, they are very shiny, but when we apply magnetic field, this shiny, glossy surface become opaque. And so we can see here the transition, which is showing us that at low magnetic field, we have a specular reflection of the laser beam from such a surface. And this specular reflection is, by increasing magnetic field, transformed to spread reflections. And we were analyzing the spreading angle as a function of magnetic field. And we have seen that the spreading angle is increasing with increasing magnetic field, reaches a value about 5 degrees in the quarter of Tesla field, and then it decreases if magnetic field is decreased. And by this information about the spread reflection, if we know what is the lateral diameter of the surface hills that are formed on the surface, and we can get this information from optical microscopy of the surface, we can then calculate the surface roughness. So we make the analysis for different sample, and here we see, for instance, for 78% sample, we can have modification of surface roughness from about 20 nanometer at very low magnetic field to about 300 nanometers when magnetic field is a quarter of Tesla. So if one would extrapolate this analysis, we would expect that one can get RMS roughness of about 1 micrometer in the field of 1 Tesla. Another interesting property is that also a total reflectivity of these materials decreasing. It decreases by increasing magnetic field. So in the beginning, we have mainly PDMS surface, so we get about 8% of the reflectivity. But when we increase magnetic field, the reflectivity in total drops below 1%. So we were also investigating how chemical composition of our samples affects these properties. And so we have found out that softer the sample are, larger are the surface optical modification in reflectivity and also in the spread reflection. And we also observed that the lower concentration of microparticle gives more and larger changes than high concentration of microparticles. So one needs soft matrix and some optimal concentration of microparticles for this property. Another thing that we were investigating, another phenomenon, was surface wetting properties. We all are aware that surface roughness, of course, can have an effect on the wetting characteristic, and that rough surfaces are typically hydrophobic. So we expected that if we put water on the surface of our magnetoactive elastomers and then we apply magnetic field, we know from previous study that surface roughness increases. So the idea was that the contact angle will also increase and the surface will become hydrophobic. And we were analyzing such droplet and applying different magnetic fields to our sample and measured contact angle with respect to the surface and the radius of droplets, which were a very low volume, so they had spherical shape. And we came actually to some surprising observation in 2 experiments. In the first one, we were depositing the droplet on the surface in the low magnetic field. We were increasing magnetic field and decreasing it again. And we observed that actually the contact angle was larger in the lower magnetic field. Then we also made an opposite experiment. So we put a droplet on the surface when the surface was exposed to magnetic field. Then we removed the surface, applied the surface again, and we can see here is a jump up. So the contact angle increases when magnetic field is lower. So the effect is just opposite to what one would expect. And so we were a bit puzzled for some time with this effect, but finally with precise inspection of the sample surface under the microscope, we could get an idea what is the reason, namely that when magnetic field is applied, this carbonyl iron particle actually protrudes to the surface. And this causes chemical modification on the surface. So in water, which is in zero magnetic field, mainly in contact with PDMS, comes more and more into contact with our carbonyl iron particles. And because we use particles which have no surface coating, and carbonyl iron is known to be very hydrophilic, so with protrusion of the particles, actually the contact angle decreases. And so we made some analysis of this effect, and we found out that in the field of 230 millitesla, about 6% of surface contact area is modified from TDMS to carbonyl iron. So the third effect that I would like to present you is the effect of magnetic field on magnetoactive elastomer, which indirectly also modifies the splashing characteristic of droplets on the surface. Here we use ethanol, which was dropped onto the magnetoactive elastomer surface from different heights. So it was the droplets were falling on the surface with different velocity. And we were characterized this phenomenon with the so-called Weber number, which is actually the ratio between the kinetic energy of the droplets and the surface energy of the droplet. And we were observing how this ejection sheet is increasing in size as a function of time and as a function of magnetic field, and also whether there are some secondary droplets which produce splashing of the liquid over the surface. And first effect we had observed was that actually the ejection sheet deceleration is drastically changing with magnetic field. We have nearly a factor of two larger deceleration in the 300 millitesla magnetic field. Another property, which was also very interesting for us to observe, is that when the magnetic field is very low and we have some reasonably height from which the droplets are released, we have very nice deposition of the droplet on the surface. So droplet falls on the surface, it makes a tiny sheet of water on the surface, and then this sheet is collecting back into the droplet form, and no additional splashing takes place, so the droplet does not make a wetting further on the surface. On the other hand, if we apply to magnetic field, for instance, about 300 millitesla, with the same conditions, we observed a lot of secondary droplets. So the ethanol was splashed all over the surface. And we were investigating how the characteristic Weber number, which is transition from the nice deposition to splashing deposition, takes place. And we observed that with increasing magnetic fields, the typical Weber number at which the splashing starts to take place is reduced. So here it has a value about 200, and here definitely below 180. And so if we now plot this on the x-axis, the Young modulus of the material for which we know that it is modified by the magnetic field, and we plot this critical Weber number as a function of Young modulus, we can see that by increasing the Young modulus of our material by applying it to magnetic field, then we can tune actually the droplet splashing characteristic. And this we can do with one and the same material. Why, for instance, this group from University in Oxford, which published some similar research some years ago, they were fabricating several different material with different compositions. And they observed a similar effect. So by this, I would like to come to the conclusion. So main conclusions from our work that I would like you maybe to remember is that surface roughness of soft magnetoactive elastomers can be dynamically tuned by variation of magnetic field, and that we can typically get a root mean square roughness in the range of 1 micrometer per tesla, which can be also reduced when magnetic field is switched off. Another thing is that magnetic field induces modification of chemical composition of the surface. So due to the protrusion of magnetic mitro particles, surface chemical structure can be modified. And this is another possibility of regulation, because by changing the surface coating for microparticles, we can then also modify this chemical modification. Both effects strongly, of course, influence optical reflection properties and also wetting characteristic on the surface of magnetoactive elastomers. And the last thing is that tuning of droplet splashing is also possible on magnetoactive elastomers because magnetic field causes modifications of material stiffness. Besides this, we believe that, of course, modifications of surface roughness and chemical composition definitely play a role also in droplet splashing, but these effects still need to be investigated in the future. With this, now I came to the last slide. With the last slide, I would like first to acknowledge my co-workers from my group in Ljubljana and at Jožef Stefan Institute and at University of Ljubljana, then several people from the Regensburg in Germany, and also people from the group at the Faculty for Mechanical Engineering at University of Ljubljana. I would also like to acknowledge the funding for our research, which is from the Slovenian Research Agency. And I would like to thank you all for your attention.